Number 1. L Player. This emulator is well known for its speed and performance, which can be crucial when you're managing multiple social media accounts or running resource-intensive apps. It also supports various Android versions, giving you the flexibility to test your social media strategies on different platforms. However, it's worth noting that L Player's interface may not be as user-friendly as some other options, which can slow down your workflow. L Player is very strong in external settings, not its internal O's. So for example, if you change your location in the location settings, your location will definitely change, unlike Memu. When you activate GPS spoofing, it will automatically move to China. Or for example, turning off root. Then your root will also turn off, including Magisk, which even has its own SU. But because it is light and strong in application settings, its settings, then this is suitable for content creators who like to play games. Number 2. Nox Player. Nox Player is another popular emulator among social media. It offers many customization options, allowing you to tailor your experience to your specific needs. This can be very useful when you're experimenting with hacking and need to customize your tools. However, Nox Player is reported to have more bugs and stability issues than some other emulators. Nox is a middle version of Eld Player and Mimu. Its external application settings are not as good as Eld Player, and its internal settings are not as good as Mimu. But because of that, this is suitable for those who like to trial and error, tinker with applications or others, but still light. That's why Nox Player is often found in internet cafes. Oh yes, if root is turned off in the settings, it will only turn off the built-in root application of the Eld Player, not the one inside, for example, Magisk or the like. So root remains active even when turned off in the settings. Number 3. Memu. Memu is known for its user-friendly interface and high compatibility with various apps. This can make it a good choice for who need to switch between different social media platforms or game quickly and efficiently. Memu also offers good performance, although possibly not as fast as Eld Player or Nox Player. In my opinion, Memu is BlueStack, but a more user-friendly and easier to use version. This is not strong for its external settings, Mu's default settings, but sometimes good for hiding the detection of fake Android by some applications. Because there are very good features like IMEI and phone numbers according to the country, and separating partitions well with the outside PC, so the application detects that Memu stands alone. That's why this app is a bit heavy like BlueStack. Suitable for use with applications that easily detect emulators, root fake Android, because actually all emulators are already rooted from the start if used on a PC, if you understand what I mean. Yes, for example, some shopping apps may still be used on Memu. Not suitable for playing games in some cases, but too good for some cases. In terms of social media and gaming, these three emulators can be valuable tools. The best for you will depend on your specific needs and preferences. For example, if speed and performance are your top priorities, L Player may be the best choice. If you value customization and flexibility, Nox Player may be more suitable. And if you're looking for a user, friendly interface and high app compatibility, Memu may be the right way to go. Additional explanation. Why I said emulators on PC are already rooted from the start, because CCs are able to access the actual root even for the CC itself, while smartphones, for example like Vimos, are like creating a fake root on unrooted phones, because again, back to the beginning, if the phone is not rooted, it means it certainly cannot use features that require real root. So you can assess for yourself which is better between PC emulators and smartphones. Yes, but to go back to the beginning, Some people find using an emulator on their smartphone comfortable because the virtual environment we use is the smartphone's operating system. So it makes it easy to use the default apps that come with the smartphone. Don't you lose sight of what